from 4 chapter 4 indices, certs and logarithm. This is the third subtopic of this chapter. Okay, law of logarithm, a power of x equals to y. You have to know how to make the index become a logarithm form. Okay, it will be look like log, the base is a, the x is index. So the base will become at here. The answer will be at here. And then equals to the index. Okay, this is in a logarithm form. There are three laws of logarithm, which is log a x y equals to log a x plus log a y. And then log a x over y is equals to log a x minus log a y. And the last one, if log a x power of n, you have to move down the n at here. Okay, and I want to share with you one more thing. The log a is equals to 1. Let me show you in the index form. It's a power of 1, which is equals to a. Okay, so I give you an example. Log 2 is equals to 1. Okay, 2 power of 1 is equals to 2. So if the number at here and here is the same, then it will be equals to 1. Okay, so let's go to the example 1. Without using calculator, evaluate this. Okay, part A, log 2, 64. Log 2, 64. We know that the 64 we can write, it become 2 power of 6. So since log 2 is here, I can use the law of a logarithm. I move the 6 to in front. So I move the 6 to here, log 2. And I apply that log 2 is equals to 1. So I can get my answer is 6. Okay, go to part B. Okay, let me copy down the question first. Okay, let's see. 1 over 9. 1 over 9, we can write it become a negative index, which is 9 power of negative 1. Since I see here is a base of 3, so I will change it become 3 power of 2, which is also equals to 9 power of negative 1. So this one is 3 power of negative 2, which I apply the law of indices here. Okay, so I substitute back 2 log 3 power of negative 2 plus 0.25, we know that is 1 over 4, which is 4 power negative 1. I can write here 4 power of negative 1 plus log 625 is equals to 5 power of 4, which is where I can move the negative 2 down. So 2 times negative 2. Log 33 become 1, so I don't need to write already. So plus, I can move the negative 1 down at here. Plus, I can move the 4 to in front, so it's equals to 4. So I can get the answer is minus 4 minus 1 plus 4, which is equals to minus 1. Okay, so the last part, part C. This is the minus 1, not plus 1, okay? It's minus 1. Okay, log 321 minus log 37 plus 1. Okay, let's see. 21 I can change to 7 times 3. Okay, I will change it to 3 times 7 is also equals to 21 minus log 37 plus 1. Okay, I apply the law of a logarithm at here. I separate it. So I will get log 3 plus log 37 minus log 37 plus 1 plus log 37 minus log 37, I will cancel off. So log 33 is equals to 1. 1 plus 1 equals to 2. Example 2, solve the following equations. 2 power x minus 1 equals to 13. Okay, I will choose to log both sides. Log 10 plus 10. Okay, 2x minus 1 equals to log 10, 13. Okay, now I will move the x minus 1 to in front, which is x minus 1 log 10, 2 equals to log 10, 13. Okay, I will times inside, become x log 10, 2 minus log 10, 2 equals to log 10, 13. So x log 10 2 equals to log 10 13 plus log 10 2. I move this to here. Alright, so my x will be log 10 13 plus log 10 2 over log 10 2. Okay, by using your calculator, you will get your answer is 4.7. Okay, for the part B, I will move the logarithm aside and integer left aside. Okay, it will be look like log 3 2x plus 1 minus log 3 x minus 7 equals to 2. I apply my law of logarithm. When it's a minus, so it is a divide. Still remember or not? Log ax minus log ay equals to log ax over y. Okay? So it will be 2x plus 1 over x minus 7 equals to 2. Okay? So I change to index form. It will be look like 3 power of 2 equals to 2x plus 1 over x minus 7. Okay? 3 power of 2 we know is 9. 9 we can make it become a fraction form, which is 9 over 1. So I can times it. So I will get 2x plus 1 equals to 9 times x minus 7. I will get 2x plus 1 equals to 9x minus 63. So I will move the x one side. So I will get 9x minus 2x, 1 plus 63. So 9 minus 2, you will get 7x equals to 64. So x is equals to 64 over 7. Example 3, given log 3x equals to 7 and log 3y equals to 3, find the following values. Okay, so log 3x over y, we know that according to law of logarithm, we know it's log 3x minus log 3y. So log 3x here is 7 minus 3, which gives you the answer of 4. Okay, this is simple. Okay, this one, I will change it become log 3y power of 2 minus log 3 square root of 3x here. Okay, now I will move down the 2 here. So it become 2 log 3y minus log 3 3x. Square root is power of half. So now half I can move down. So 2 log 3y minus half log 3 3x. So 3x, I also can split it up. So become log 3y minus half log 3 3 plus log 3x. Okay, now I can substitute the number inside. So equals to log 3y is equals to 3 minus half. Log 3 3 is equals to 1 plus log 3x is equals to 7. So I can get my answer. 2 times 3 equals to 6 minus half. 1 plus 7 is equals to 8. So it's 6 minus 4 is equals to 2. Example 4, given m power of x is equals to p, m power of y is equals to q, express the following in terms of x or and y. Okay, now I will change the index form into logarithm form before I start to do the question. Okay, m power of x is equals to p. I want to change it in logarithm form. It will be look like log m p equals to x, and m power of y equals to q. Change to logarithm form. It will be log m q equals to y. Okay, now I start the part A. Log m, now I can apply the law of logarithm. I split it up. So log m p power of 3 plus log m q power of 2. Okay, so now I want to put the 3 and 2 in front. So it will become 3 log m p plus 2 log m q. Now I can substitute the x and y inside. It will be 3x plus 2y. Now we go to the part B. Log m, since it's divide, I can directly split it out, okay? Square root of qm minus log mp, okay? We know that square root is power of half, so I can put the half here, log m qm minus log mp, okay? Equals to half. Now I want to split these two, okay? Log mq plus log mm minus log mp. So now I can substitute my x and y inside. It will be log mq is equals to y plus log mm is equals to 1 minus log mp is equals to x. Then you will get your answer as half y plus half minus x. In the subtopic of log logarithm, you have to know another thing is changing the base of logarithm. It will be useful when you solve your equation, okay? Log ab, if I want to change the base, then I can split it out, become log a and log b. Then I can choose any base that I want. For example, I choose c. If I choose C, upstairs is C, downstairs also have to be C. Cannot upstairs is C and downstairs is D. Cannot, okay? Must be the same, okay? And in case I want to change my B become the base, then I can directly inverse it, which is 1 over log BA, okay? I have an example to show you this. Given log P4 equals to M and log 2Q is equals to N, express in term of M or N. Part A, log 2, 4 P squared. Okay, apply the law of logarithm. I can split out. Okay, I will split out first. Become log 2, 4 plus log 2 P squared. Here, I know that I can move the 2 in front. And then the 4 is log 2, 2. Log 2 power of 2 plus 2 log 2p, okay? So now I also can move the 2 in front and this will become 2 only because log 2, 2 is equals to 1. So 2 plus 2 log 2p. And I see my equation. I don't have log 2p. I have log p4. Okay, then I will try to change this, okay? Log p4 is equals to log 4 over log p. Now I can choose my base. Since my equation 1 log 2p, so I will choose 2. Okay, so log 4 is 2 power of 2, and then log 2p, I remain here. So upstairs I will get 2, I move down, I will get a 2 upstairs, so it's log 2p. So I know that 2 over log 2p is equals to m. So I know that log 2p is equals to 2 over m. So now I can substitute back to here. So equals to 2 plus 2, 2 over m, which is my answer is 2 plus 4 over m. Okay? Now we look at this. Log q at pq squared. Okay. Apply the law of logarithm. I will split it up. Become log q at plus log q p plus log q q squared. From here, log q at I don't have the information. Log q p I also don't have the information. So now I will change the base of logarithm. Log a over log q plus log p over log q plus log qq is equals to 1, 2 I bring down. So now here left the 2. Now I need to choose the base. What base I will choose? I will choose 2 because the question log 2q is equals to n. So I will choose 2. Right? Log 2, and I can become 2 power of 3. Log 2q I know is n plus log 2p here. I can apply it here. So it's 2 over m over log 2q is equals to n plus 2. So I will be getting 3 over n plus 2 over mn plus 2. Here is your answer. Okay? Example 2, given that log 3p is equals to a and log 27q is equals to b, express this in term of a and b. Okay, log 9 square root of p power of 4 q power of 3. I know that square root is power of half, so I can directly move the half to in front, which is log 9 p power of 4 q power of 3. Now I can split the p and q. Equals to half log 9 p power of 4 plus log 9 q power of 3. I can see from here I don't have this information. So what can I do? I must change the base. Okay. Before changing the base, I will move down the power first. So half 4 log 9 p plus 3 log 9 q goes to, I times the half first, so I can get 2 log 9 p plus 3 over 2 log 9 q. Now I want to change the base already. Okay, log p over log 9 plus 3 over 2 log q over log 9. Now what should I choose the best? Okay, for here, from my question, is log 3p. So of course, I will choose 3 here. From the question, here is 27. So I will choose 27 at here. Okay, so now I can see log 3p is equals to a. So I know that a over log 39 equals to how many? Log 39 equals to log 3, 9 is 3 power of 2. So I can know that is equals to 2. So here is the 2 plus 3 over 2. Log 27q, you know is a b. And how about this? So I will do it here. Log 27, 9 is equals to log 9 over log 27. I change the base again. Okay? I change it become 3. Because I know that 3 power of 2, I can get 9. And 3 power of 3, I can get 27. So log 3, 3 power of 2. Log 3, 3 power of 3. So I move the 2 and 3 in front. I can get 2 over 3. Because log 3, 3 is equals to 1. So here is 2 over 3. Now I can simplify this. I can get a plus 3 over 2 times 3 over 2 b, which is equals to a plus 9 over 4 b. Example 3, solve the following equation. Okay, log k 625 minus log square root k 5k equals to 4. Okay, when you see the base is not the same, don't nervous. Okay, let's see what we can do first. The first thing, we can split the 5k here. Okay, log k 625 minus log square root of k 5 plus log square root of k equals to 4. Okay, after you split it out, then you have to think, how can I make it all become the same base? Okay, so I will do like this. Log 5 over log square root of k plus log k over square root of log k equals to 4. Now I have to choose my base. So I will choose, of course, is k. So I can have the same base for all the question here. Okay, so now I will do the third law of logarithm, which is log k 625, I can make it become 5 power of 4 minus log k 5. Here log k, I can become half here. Okay, plus log k is equals to 1 over law k k power of half is equals to 4. Okay, now I can move all the power to in front, become 4 log k 5 minus log k 5 over half minus negative positive, you will get negative at here, 1 over half is equals to 4. Okay, so now I can rearrange it, become log k 5 minus 2 log k 5 minus 2 is equals to 4. 4 log k 5 minus 2 log k 5, you will get 2 log k 5 equals to 4 plus 2, you will get 6. Then log k 5 is equals to 3 because you divide by 2. And then I make it become index form, k power of 3 is equals to 5. Then I can get my answer, k is equals to sub 5 of index 3. Okay, now we go to part B. The same way, you can see that the base is not the same. Don't be nervous. Let's see what we can do for the first law of logarithm first. This, okay? I can split it up, okay? Equals to log p 256 minus log square root of p index of 3 2 plus equals to 2. Okay, you see, I'm using the same technique. Then I will try to find the same base. Okay, log p 256 minus log 2 log of p index of 3 plus log p log equals to 2. Now I have to choose my base. What base I will choose? Of course, is p. Okay, equals to, now I can change the 256. I will change it, become log p 2 power of 8 minus log p 2 over log p. I know that this is p power of 1 over 3 minus negative positive, you will get negative here. Okay, log pp, you will get 1 here. So log pp 1 over 3 equals to 2. So now I can move all the power in front. So this will be equals to 8 log p 2 minus log p 2 over 1 over 3 minus 1 over 1 over 3 is equals to 2. No equal at here. Then I can continue it with, rearrange it. At log p 2 minus 3 log p 2 minus 3 equals to 2. At minus 3, you will get 5 log p 2 equals to 5. So log p 2 is equals to 1. I change to index form, p power of 1 is equals to 2. So I can know my answer is p equals to 2. So from here, as a summary for this subtopic, you can see my technique. I will use my first and second law of logarithm first. You see, this is my first step. I will split it out first. You see, this is my first step. I will split it out first. And my second step is what? My second step is changing the base. Okay, I will do the same thing. I will change the base to make sure they have all the same base. Okay, and then the last part, I will move the integer, which is my third law of logarithm. You can see all I share is applied in the question. Okay, this is a guidance for you when you answer the question. This is not a must, it must follow this way, but it is a guidance for you when you totally blank and don't know what to do in the exam. Okay, I have finished the first three subtopics. Now left the last one, will be in the next video. Okay, bye.